said, I see quite a few boys also welcome. You know, helping girls children does not exclude boys. Not at all. It includes boys. I'll tell you how. Now, this committee is constituted as there is a directive from the Government of India, our ordinance, and also the topic is of extreme importance, not only in our country, but all over the world. Safety and security of women. Safety and security of women, where? Everywhere. We are not at the moment touching the family inside your homes, but any public place. It can be university, offices, institutions, any kind of institutions. All of us are members of this body called SPARSH. Now I'll tell you what is the constitution of SPARSH in our university. Now we have a committee. The committee has two wings. One wing is called AB SPARSH, that is apex body. The other is University Complaints Committee. In AB SPARSH, we have representatives from all sections of people in the university. I'm Jayashree Mohan Raj. I happen to be the chairperson of this committee. We have a senior faculty, Dr. Shruti Sarkar. Can you just stand up, please? And we have the Dean Students Welfare, Dr. Professor Samson. Now, we have from the Foreign Languages Wing, three professors, faculty members on the committee. One is Dr. Matthew John. And we have Dr. Anjali Bagde. She was here in the last session. We had one more session with the foreign languages students. And we also have Mr. Suryakant, who is in the Department of Japanese, Chinese, and Korean languages. We have the deputy proctor, Dr. Sujata Mukri. You have seen her, you have met her, you have interacted with her many times already, I think. She is an active member of this committee. And apart from us, we also have two student representatives. Ms. Jyoti, she's not here. She's gone out perhaps to have tea. She was here in the last. She's a PhD scholar. She topped the list in the, I think, previous year when she joined. One more student will be inducted, because another student passed out of the university, so we need to replace her. So we have two student representatives in the committee. We also have a representative from the non-teaching or support staff on our committee. Now, apart from these people who are inside our university or members of the university, we also have three very important and eminent people on our committee. One is Dr. Sheila Sara Matthew, who is a very active member, or not member, he is a founder trustee of a group which does a lot of work supporting the women's cause called Sankalp. It's an NGO. So we have her on our committee. We have a legal expert, an advocate from the High Court, Ms. Rachna Reddy Bollu. Her name also is here. She's our legal advisor, because these are very sensitive issues and we have to go according to the law of the land. So we have her on our committee to offer us, to give the proper legal directive. Then we have another very important person on our committee, Dr. Kumarangan, your counselor. She is here, and her role is very important inside SPARSH and outside also, I would consider. Thank you, Dr. Uma, for making it for this session. Why did I say it's important to have Dr. Kumarangan here? You see, the name SPARSH is an acronym, and what does it expand to? Sensitization, prevention, and redressal of sexual harassment. Look at the order of the words. It is first sensitization. We are now doing this exercise in our university as the first program under this banner, SPARSH. Now that's very important. Now, we have to be aware of so many issues which are concerning the girl students and women in our society. We have to be aware of it. We have to be sensitive to the cause. We have to be sensitive to the fact that certain actions of ours may be very uncomfortable for the girl or woman who is with us. Now, all that will be explained later by Dr. Sujata Mukti. I'm not going into it. The next word is prevention. Prevention of sexual harassment. How do you prevent sexual harassment? By not harassing, and by stopping somebody from doing it. Now for that, we need to create an atmosphere of dialogue. Those of you who are standing, can you just come and sit? Have a seat, please. Please do come. Please come in. Respecting each other, and also conducting ourselves with a lot of responsibility. Responsibility of conduct and respect for each other definitely will prevent any kind of problem. So this is what we are emphasizing. Now it's only the third stage, that is redressal. So if you cannot prevent something, if you cannot make somebody sensitive towards a girl, then there you can lodge a complaint. That is why we have what you call UCC, that is University Complaints Committee. Now we will, if a complaint is lodged and a complaint is either orally made to any of these members, we have given you our contact phone numbers as well as the email IDs. You can make your complaint to any of us or to the university SPARSH, the email ID of SPARSH. You can write a complaint there. We will definitely and very promptly take up the complaint and do investigations and also take punitive measures. We are very, very, very serious about it. The university is very serious about it. In the past, there were some cases, and those cases were very sternly dealt with. I'm not trying to create any fear in you. but I am trying to instill in you confidence and also a sense of responsibility. This is what we want in our university. And if we are serious about each other, if we can contribute to a very friendly environment, then what will happen? There will be zero complaint. There will be no complaint as far as sexual harassment is concerned. Now this is what we are aiming at. There will be, but if there is a complaint, there will be zero tolerance. Prompt action will be taken against the perpetrator. Be it a student, fellow student, be it a faculty member, be it an outsider, or be it a non-teaching staff. If you feel uncomfortable in the actions of any of these people, then you can lodge a complaint. So have confidence that you have safety and security on the campus. Have confidence that your complaint will be definitely, your complaint will be heard and will be acted upon. We want to instill in you this confidence. At the same time, we want to tell the boys that if you have complaint, there is another body called Proctorial Committee. You can definitely lodge your complaint there. When we make a complaint, we should be responsible towards the complaint as well. No trivial complaints will be entertained. No anonymous complaints will be entertained by the university. We will go strictly by our ordinance, which is printed, and this brochure has taken guidance from this ordinance and also two other acts in operation in our country. The Nirbhaya Act, Vishaka guidelines, and the GOI, Government of India directives. So we will take stern action. At the same time, we would not like you to give us that opportunity to take action against sexual harassment. Now, more details about what sexual harassment is, what are the punitive measures, and who can you, how can you make a complaint, all this will be explained to you by Dr. Sujata Mukhi. Please.
And all my colleagues sitting over here. And this is the second session we're doing it. We are repeating what we talked. But it will be definitely an improved session because we faced with a lot of questions from the students. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Jashri Mohanraj, for giving me this opportunity. This session is not to scare anybody or not to put fears in boys or anything. It is just that we want to remind you of the sexual harassment laws, the university ordinances, which strictly go against sexual harassment, and moreover, to explain what constitutes sexual harassment, because we have this traditional thought that sexual harassment is only physically touching someone without their consent, and it happens only in the dark areas or maybe lonely places or when there's nobody around. And then we also think that only sexual harassment is properly, sexually harassing a person. That is the only thing. We used to think like that. But there are three judgments in India which change or which redefine what is sexual harassment. Number one is Mathura rape case. I mentioned it earlier, but I did not discuss the case actually. There was a very, there was a girl called Mathura who was raped earlier in the 1970s. Okay, the judgment came out saying that because she had a real relationship with her boyfriend, and it is difficult to judge whether this could be bordered as sexual harassment or rape or something. That was one incident. And in 1997, a social worker was raped in Rajasthan. okay, which raised again several questions about what constitutes sexual harassment. And one recent case which all of us are aware of is Nirbhaya case, which actually changed the entire scenario and redefined sexual harassment laws in this country. Okay, in that light, it is important for us to understand what constitutes sexual harassment, number one. Okay, so end of the last session, some boys came and asked, what if the girl pleases the boys? Okay, 1 in 100 or maybe 5 in 100, it's a different case, but there is a mechanism where you can complain on the boys. Okay, we'll discuss that little later because I seriously thought that we should address that issue also. So if you, I was talking about a survey which was conducted at Mumbai University in 2007 and which also specified the statistics of sexual harassment level in the Indian universities and colleges. Okay, it is noted that every minute, every 51 minutes, a girl is sexually harassed, and every 23 minutes, a girl is sexually molested in the Indian universities or colleges, wherever it is, academic institutions. But unfortunately, you know, there is a lot of silence about these incidents because this is not something which you openly discuss. That is a wrong, okay, that is a misconception actually, not to complain or not to discuss is a crime itself. Okay, so here, let us look at what constitutes sexual harassment. All these three last define sexual harassment in three different ways. One is verbal, the other one is non-verbal, and the third one is physical. Okay, we'll have a quick look at what constitutes sexual harassment. Then, while reading that, we'll also discuss what usually happens on the campus and how to deal with these problems. This is verbal. Can you all see that? People are sitting in the last? Last row? Yes. Turning ordinary or academic discussions to sexual topics. Sometimes you sit with your friend to do your assignment and then suddenly the topic diverts. If the girl complains, if the girl is uncomfortable with the conversation, she can file a complaint and it can border on sexual harassment. And asking about sexual fantasies, preferences or history. Okay, just because the other girl dreams, it is taken as that this girl is very free and very liberal so that we can take her for granted is also a sexual harassment. Our personal questions about social or sexual life, sexual comments about a person's clothing, anatomy or looks. I was referring to a case which took place last year. Okay, one of our students was actually wearing linen shorts and somebody comes and tells, kya cheez lag rahi ho, kya maalum hai, fir he explains. Okay, then there was a complaint in the proctor's office and that was the last day of the semester. That boy was supposed to leave the institution. Even then, on the last minute, we called him and we issued a notice. We asked for explanations, talked to witnesses, and then because, you know, that girl was, all the girl wanted at that point of time was an apology, so we made him write an apology. Okay? So incidences like that can border on sexual harassment. Had the boy continued, things would have been different. Okay? And kissing sounds, howling and smacking lips are spreading rumors about a person's personal life. Sometimes you propose and the girl doesn't like you. She rejects it. She turns down. Then you're very angry and you want to go on, you know, talking about her rumors, you dig out the past history, and then you try to do what is called character assassination, which borders on sexual harassment. Again, earlier it was not. Then unwelcome sexual comments or jokes that continue, even though the recipient has indicated that those behaviors are unwelcome. Sorry for the typo there. So sometimes, you know, you think that you're, I just mean this. Sometimes you try to explain, I just mean this. I don't mean that, and everything. But if the girl is offended, you know, you talk double meaning words, you use phrases, dialogues, things like that, which is offensive. I mean, offensive. Right? Behavior, okay. Calling girls with nicknames. If the girl doesn't like it, stop it. Me calling them by nicknames or pet names or, you know, whatever the family calls them. And describing or interpreting her dress, physical appearance, in, okay. in an obscene manner. Sometimes you come and say, most commonly used word is you are looking very sexy. Okay? Which is not really right to do. If a girl complains, that could be a case against. Okay, so watch out what you are saying. You can't use these words with your friends just because they are girls, and you can't comment on their dresses. Passing disparaging comments. Okay, talking about sexual harassment is not only physically harassing someone or sexually harassing someone, but also making them feel that you are very powerful and the other sex is not. Showing your power sometimes, warning them. Okay, talking loudly and saying and threatening them, that also could border on sexual harassment. That is verbal. Okay, sometimes a very frequent thing that happens on our campus is sometimes the boy and girl are in a relationship, and then by personal reasons or by other reasons or familial reasons, the girl decides to opt out of the relationship, stay out of the relationship. Then you keep on pestering, forcing her, writing letters or threatening her and all, is also sexual harassment. And I've seen cases on this campus that, if the girl has another friend, this boy would go and threaten that other boy. And then sometimes telling the girl that you call your parents and tell her, that kind of thing. Okay? If they come to our notice, it will be treated very seriously, because you have to respect everyone's space. Each individual has a right to be herself, right to maintain her identity, her space, her respect, everything. Sexual harassment is no longer a physical abuse alone. Okay? It is also outraging woman's modesty, disrespecting her. So please remember these things. And verbal could be, verbal. Non-verbal, sometimes your body language speaks more than words speak. Okay, sometimes you pose and then you look at them frequently, stare at them, give them kind of uncomfortable looks, looking a person up and down. Okay? Especially when the other person is very uncomfortable, you don't even stop doing that. Then staring at someone, blocking a person's path, sometimes deliberately coming in the way and then touching, trying to touch, and following the person. Sometimes when she goes for a walk on the campus or outside, you just follow and be around her only, hang out wherever she is. That one, displaying sexually suggestive visuals, and then making sexual gestures with hands or through body movements. Making facial expressions such as winking, throwing kisses or licking lips, something really, you can make out. You may not be able to prove, but you can make out. But when there is a complaint, okay, definitely action will be taken, at least reprimand. We'll come to the university ordinances and what are the punishments listed over there little later. But hope you understand the sense and spirit of it. Alright? Sometimes you behave in such a manner that you're very powerful, you can look at her. I'm standing here and looking, but I'm not looking at you. Blatantly refuse. I'm not looking at you. Okay? Or sometimes you openly come at you, yeah, you're looking good, so I'm looking at you. Either way, it is punishing. Then physical is actual attempted rape or sexual assault. All of us know that. And unwanted pressure for sexual favors. Unwanted deliberate touching, leaning over, cornering or pinching. Sometimes if a girl is alone, maybe you try to stop her. No, I want to talk to you for a while. Please stop here. The girl doesn't want to stop, but you want to stop her physically. Say, you be here and just listen to me, one last time or one first time, whatever. It's also sexual harassment. Touching a person's clothing, hair or body. Sometimes you say your name. As if you're complimenting, you take the hand and say, oh, you have beautiful fingers. Or your nail polish is very good. A nice dress, you're looking very beautiful or sexy, whatever. Hugging and patting. Sometimes you pat as if you're very close to the other person. Even with your close friends, you're not supposed to do that. Okay, if they don't like it, especially if they express it once, you should stop doing that. Then standing close or brushing up against other person, and anything which comes close to these three types of behaviors is sexual harassment. Okay, we are mentioning some extracted from these three acts, and then just to define sexual harassment, that is threatening the other's face, is sexual harassment. Alright? Then, our university ordinances. As Dr. Jayashree Mohan has mentioned, okay, this is a committee for sensitization. Okay, before anything happens, prevention is better than cure, so we sensitize people. We want you to know that women has a body and a mind of her own, okay, and she is entitled to respect,